who are on the chain and are being sponsored by lobbyists who don't have your best interests at heart. These are probably what's called international stock market capitalists or Zionist cabal bankers who own them to a man. The only other way around it is to force by-elections, because I assure you that if you trade it for Canada down the road with a general election, all you're going to do is have an upper say. You're going to have the same old porridge spooned down your throat for another 4 to 8 years. And as you can see in France at the moment, the French aren't, they're not politicking, they're not going on the street against Emmanuel Macron per se. They're on the street because they've had enough of that tried and untrusted non-democratic process. People's voices are not listened to, and the message from Europe is generally the same. You'll notice in Germany and in Belgium that the Gilets Jaunes or the Yellow Vest movement is well underway. And what I also am very, very happy to say is it is amazing to see the support from Manchester's finest. They actually are wearing their yellow jackets in full support of the people. So let's hear it for Manchester's finest, because many of you might not be aware of who the individual standing behind me is, and he is the father of British policing, Sir Robert Peel. The name of the Peelers, or the Bobbies, is a direct derivation from Sir Robert Peel. And Sir Robert Peel, who was from this Manchester area, basically stated there was only one type of policing, and that policing was policing by consent, that the people were the police and the police were the people. And one of the fundamental tenets of policing is that they have a mandate from the people to police them. Invariably, the police methodology of action should be for intercepting crime and protecting the people. Once the action moves into a civil domain, and it is a civil protest, then it is very, very questionable as to what rights the police have to directly intervene or interfere with the will of the people, as long as they're not committing destruction to the property. So why I mention this, I've seen many of these yellow vest protests where they try to be kettled in, or they try to say, okay, you can only proceed here, you can't go left, you can't go outside the BBC offices. That is nothing to do with police. And when we are going to open this can of worms further down the road, when we look further down the road, and I start to expose the degree of corruption within something called the ACPO, which is the Association Chief of Police Officers, we will begin to examine some of these possibilities. So, what I would actually do is emphasise... I would just emphasise the fact that Manchester's finest are here in full support of us today. I'm glad to see them wearing their yellow vests, even though they've got this police on their back. So, a round of applause for Manchester's finest. Amen! And why I'm mentioning this, many of you may not know that the police and the military and many other individuals within our great country are very much behind the concept of the mandate that was given, the vote for us to leave, being enacted. So, many of the police, don't forget, even though they're wearing these uniforms, could well have voted for the leave and remain. So it doesn't matter which side of the counter they're on, they are here to help us uphold this democratic process. There are many also within the military that are also very for the actual leaving, because the military are very concerned that they don't want to get wrapped up in an Angela Merkel, Emmanuel Macron type of European army. We are here to defend our own borders, not those borders of the French or the Belgians. So my good friend here, James, wants to make a bit of a statement now. He's got something to read, so I'm going to hand over the microphone to him.
So what we need to do is we need to wake up all the sheep that have stood on that side. I know, I can see the police are already using their tactics against us. Huh? Oh.
Spread about. Spread about, they can't get up.
Okay, so... So anyway, I'm going to continue just speaking on behalf of the prime reason I'm here today is to talk about Brexit. And it's really the Brexit vote that is important. And what's trying to be done is that the what I would call people who are in a traitorous disposition to you in the House of Westminster, from the Speaker of the House, which is this chap Burko, who is overriding the constitutional authority of the parliamentarians, and also to people like the ex-Attorney General, which is Dominic Grieve, who knows me very well. Also, the traitor who is sitting on the left side of Jeremy Corbyn, someone called Keir Starmer, who is Sir Keir Starmer, so you can imagine where his loyalty lies. Sir Keir Starmer, ex-head of the Crown Prosecution Service. And as you can see, there are many individuals within Parliament who do not wish you to leave the European Union because they are being paid and they are compromised by lobbyists out of Brussels. So if you actually research who controls who, and you can see very interesting documentaries on the corruption within the Brussels business model, you can see why it's not beyond a degree of credibility that you are being socially engineered into remaining within the European Union. A question would be, why are you being forced to remain, and why is it that they don't want you out? And the simple reason is they want you to stay in a club of which they have control over you so that they can make you compliant and obey these laws that are coming from non-democratically elected organisations in Brussels. So you are being ruled, you are being policed by people who don't have your best interests in honour, and so I don't know whether the main thing here is to say that things when there is political argument, when there is political discussion, what we've got to remember here is, as far as the Yellow Vest movement in the United Kingdom is, and I think apart from in London and Leeds, there is a group of here in Manchester, what we're getting here, and we must do this, we must ensure that ultimately we take the police along with us. And though that sounds maybe a little utopian, it's inevitable, because eventually, if the conflict that the will of the people is not being adhered to and is not being formulated, then what happens is people go on the street, people protest and demonstrate, and inevitably a movement with a very good pedigree gets infiltrated very easily by those elements that want to cause the violence and destruction. So unfortunately, revolution always has a price, and the price of that is usually members of the monarchy, not forbid it should happen to ours, being shortened by a head. But that's the way of nature, and that's the way it is. So, Father James, are you wants to say?
It's my message, Tracy, so she knows we're doing it.
Yeah, I've got it when they walk right in front of us as well. So.
Is he still recording now?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you want me to keep it recording?
But not.
Right, forward. Just Georgia! Just